So if Hindus stop believing in idols and pictures and they start believing in the Almighty, which has got no form, no shape, and on the day of judgment, is it that they will be not behaved as Muslims by God? No, it is not like that. It is the concept which is there in Hinduism, the misbelief that is followed in forms. But if an Hindu, following Hindu religion is not wrong, but following, because your aim is God, He is the supreme, He should not have form.
Very
But
good question.
if this message is reached to Hinduism, you have won it.
Very good sister. Very good question.
Thank you, sir.
Regarding we being partial and impartial, there can be two different views from your side. Because we're partial, at least you could ask a question. If I wasn't partial, I couldn't tell to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I gave you the message directly, one to one. You know? So
he doesn't believe.
So what you have to realize, sister, but why we are partial? We are partial to be impartial. Because the others have got the message. If not 100%, 90%. You all have got less. So we are partial to be impartial.
Right, sir. So what we
now
need
coming
to
back to your question, sister.
Yes,
it's
sir.
A very good question. That if the Hindus believe in one God, do not believe in idol, do not believe in images, do not believe in statues, on the day of judgment, won't we be Muslims? Correct. You are following part of Islam. Correct. If you read the Hindu scriptures further, the Hindu scriptures say there is another messenger to come. And the coming of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, has been prophesied in various places. He's prophesied in Bhavishya Purana, Parva 3, Khanda 3, Adhyay 3, Shloka 5 to 8. He's prophesied in Bhavishya Purana, Parva 3, Khanda 3, Adhyay 3, Shloka 10 to 27. He's prophesied in the Atharva Ved, chapter number 21, verse number 6. Atharva Ved, chapter number 21, verse number 7. He is prophesied in several places. He is mentioned by name no less than 100 times as Muhammad in the Hindu scriptures.
Right,
time
sir.
Doesn't permit me to mention all the references. There is mention of a Kalki Avatar in Kalki Purana, chapter number 2, verse number 4, 5, 7, 9, 11, and 15. It says that there is another Avatar to come, Kalki Avatar, whose father's name shall be the servant of God, Vishnu Yash, translated into Arabic as Abdullah, which was the name of the father of Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. The mother's name of this Kalki Avatar would be Sumati, that means peace and serenity, which is Amina in Arabic, which was the name of Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, mother. This person would be born on the 12th day of Madhav, the 12th Rabbi Awal, that is the Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam born. He'll have four companions, and we know the first for Khulafa Rashidin. It says that he will be born in a place which is peaceful, in Makkah. He'll be born in a house of the chief of Makkah, that is the Quraysh tribe. It says that he will go northwards from a cave and come back. And Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam went from Makkah to Medina and came back. On and on, talking about Kalki Avatar. So you believe in one part, La ilaha illallah, you also
Muhammad
have to believe in Muhammad Rasulullah.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
And if you do this, you keep your name, whatever your name was, whether Preeti, whatever name, sister. What is the name, sister?
Pooja.
Pooja. You keep your name. Don't change your name. But indeed, you will be a Muslim. Changing your name is not required.
So the concept?
Concept of one God? No statue, no images. Last final messenger, Prophet Muhammad. Inshallah, on the day of judgment, you will go to heaven with your name Pooja.
So the pathways are different. The only thing is the goal should be the same. That is
no,
what
sister,
I believe.
For the goal, pathways are different. If both the different pathways go to
meet,
the same goal,
they
it is
meet
fine.
At the same goal. Yes, sir. That is what I want to say.
All the roads don't lead to Rome, sister. Fine? You may think it will lead. So if you think falsely, I have to correct you.
I don't believe. No, sir.
No, sister, if you say you're a Hindu, by definition, Hindu is a person who lives in India.
No, sir. It's not like that.
Sister, Hindu is a geographical definition. You don't know. I know. I'm a Hindu by geographical definition. I'm a Hindu. Geographically, sister, the word Hindu was first used by the Arabs. There are many Arabs here. They call me Hindi when I go there. Hindi, Hindi. They tell I'm a Hindu. The word Hindu was first used by the Arabs when they came to India. It was also used by the Persians to describe the people who lived in India. So geographically, I'm a Hindu. But if you tell me religiously, Hindu is a misnomer. Swami Vivekananda said, the right term is a Vedantist. You should follow the Vedas. So as far as you follow the right things in the Veda, believe in one God and believing in Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, by deed you are a Muslim.
Sir, So the religion can't be powerful. The ultimate power is Allah.
Correct.
Right? Ultimate power is God.
And the religion of God. And the religion of God is ultimate religion.
So the religion of God is not Islam. The religion of God is not Islam.
Islam, if Islam is Arabic word which is hurting you, you keep Islam aside.
No. It's not hurting me.
I'm telling you, sister.
It's not hurting me.
If it's not hurting you, nobody.
No, sir. It is a Pak word in itself. How it can hurt anybody? At least not an educated girl.
Mashallah, you're an educated girl, sister.
Yes. Thank you so much. Thank you,
sister. Islam means submitting a will to God. So if Islam is a problem, keep Islam aside, but submit your will to God. Allah says in the Quran in Surah Al-Imran chapter 3 verse number 19, "Inna dina indallahi al-Islam," the only religion, the only way of life accepted in the sight of Allah is submitting a will to Almighty God.
Yes, brother.
Mr. Naik, this is myself, Dr. Suryakant Pawar from St. George Hospital. Thanks for the nice and enlightening lecture about the Quran as God's word. As you mentioned that Quran is God's word, I just want to ask you, who is the creator of the God? What is the origin of God?
The brother asked a very good question, that if Quran is the word of God, who is the creator of God? Very good question. If I ask you, brother, that your friend John, he gave birth to a child. Can you guess the child was girl or a boy? Your friend John gave birth to a child in the hospital. Can you guess, was it a girl or a boy? Guess.
No.
Girl or a boy?
I can't guess.
Sorry?
I may not guess.
Try. At least 50% you'll get right.
Yeah, 50%. One half chance.
Okay, tell me.
Boy.
Brother, can a man give birth to a child?
No.
So is it a girl or a boy?
But the name can be called a female.
I'm asking you, your friend John. I don't know anyone female called by John.
No, we can call. No.
Okay, suppose a friend who's a boy, is a man. He went to hospital. He gave birth to a child. Was it a girl or a boy?
Girl.
Can a man give birth to a child, brother?
No.
Now you understood. A man can't give birth to a child. So where's the question of it being girl or a boy? So by definition, God is uncreated. So the question, who is the creator of God? It's like I asking you a question, your friend who's a man, he gave birth to a child, is it a girl or a boy? The question is illogical. Because by definition, a man cannot give birth to a child. So where's the question of girl or a boy? So by definition, God is uncreated. Every created thing has a creator. God does not have a creator. Therefore, in my argument with the atheist, I never ever said that everything has a creator. I said every created thing has a creator. But the God is uncreated. By definition, the moment I mention who is the creator of God, he is not God. Therefore, by definition, God is uncreated. Hope that answers the question.
Okay, thank you.
The next question from the brother in the back.
My name is Peter. I'm a student of religion philosophy. Now, my question is on the textual authenticity of the Quran. First, when Abu Bakr commanded Zayd to gather the text together, he did that. But there is also written in Al-Bukhari, volume number 5, page 96, Abdul ibn Mas'ud, he was the authority mentioned by Muhammad, he gathered a text. Then Salim, the freed slave, he gathered a text, and also Ubay ibn Ka'b, a master reciter mentioned by Muhammad. And there are also other people who compiled their text. But when Usman became the Khalifa, he ordered Zayd to make seven replicas of his text and sent it to the different parts and ordered those previous texts to be burned.